Now I have the honor, we have one more award to present. It's Farm Bureau's highest award, the Distinguished Service Award. Please turn your attention to the screen.
The Distinguished Service Award is the highest honor that Farm Bureau bestows upon an individual. We reserve this honor for someone who has truly made a difference in the lives of Mississippi farmers. At the business session of the Farm Bureau annual meeting in 1996, a new era was born here in Mississippi.
Ladies and gentlemen, David Wade has been elected president of the Farm Bureau Federation.
Mr. Wade's goals when elected were to further strengthen the organization's already powerful voice in the Mississippi legislature and to raise its visibility and clout in the regulatory field.
The most pressing thing, I think, at this point is to get this pesticide licensing straightened out. That is something to me that is critical that we get done in the next 10 to 15 days if it's possible.
U.S. farmers are subject to regulations that are a lot more restrictive than most nations. Farm Bureau has tried to level the playing field.
We tried to expand the role from just being in the legislative arena all the time to informing the regulators the impact that their decisions had on our ability to produce food, and that became a real focus throughout my administration.
Mr. Wade had the opportunity to have input on three different farm bills during his tenure as president. Each one affected agriculture a little differently, but they all had the same goal: to keep the farmer on the farm and in business.
You've got a lot of variables when you're involved in agriculture, not the least of which is weather. And nobody knows what the weather's going to be like when you go purchase your seed or your fertilizer, your fuel, your input cost on a crop. And you certainly don't have any assurance of making an average crop. It's in agriculture, the years and the production is cyclical. Some years you do well, some years you don't make as much. And so if you look at it, or at least I've always tried to look at it over a five-year period, if you can be profitable three out of 5 years, you can probably stay on the farm. You'd like to be profitable every year, but given all the factors that are against you at times, it's just not possible to do that. So if we can maintain profitability, though, we can also maintain a food supply that the consumer can expect to have as a reasonable expectation, that safe, abundant food supply that we talk about. And given the programs that we've got in place now, I think it's really brought us to a point that maybe we wouldn't be as a country, because had we not had domestic agriculture, I think we'd be in the same situation we are with the energy situation, where we're dependent on some foreign country, and in most cases, countries that don't even like us.
In 2005, the most devastating hurricane to ever hit the United States mainland smashed straight into Mississippi. It wiped out most of the Gulf Coast and much of South Mississippi agriculture. But some positive things did come from Katrina through the efforts of Farm Bureau.
The farm community pulled together, and farmers that were just totally devastated managed to get money through the Farm Bureau all over the United States. And I don't know of the rows of wire in the post and the diesel fuel and all that we distributed during the immediate post of Katrina. But I think it made the agriculture community pull together.
Fuel was a precious commodity during the aftermath of Katrina. Farm Bureau led the efforts to get fuel to farmers.
We were able to get, I don't know how many transport loads we ended up getting, somewhere around 20, 25, I think, that we were able to get and to distribute to the people that were not able to get it. We managed to keep generators running to keep power to their production facilities, and ultimately really reduce the number of head of livestock that would have been lost had we not been able to do that.
Increasing the visibility of agriculture with the general consumer has been one of Mr. Wade's priorities. One of the ways that this has been accomplished was the switch from a tabloid newspaper to a slick, full-color magazine as a way to tell about Mississippi agriculture.
I thought it would be good if we had something that could convey that message to the individuals that were reading our literature, and I think that was the motivating factor behind trying to create what's now Mississippi Farm Country.
Another effort to inform the public about the importance of agriculture is the ongoing Ag Image campaign.
Telling agriculture story is critical. We've got so many issues today because of some of the security risk that we have in our food supply, just because of the regulation that we have trying to produce the food. Those issues need to be at least shown to the public so they'll understand what we do from the time we get up until we go to bed at night in trying to keep a safe, abundant food supply.
The Ag Image campaign had a positive impact in its first year on the air.
Farm families of Mississippi is getting to be something that the consumer is aware of, and the fact that it's real farmers making the advertisement about what farmers do every day, I think means a lot to the consuming public, because it's not somebody that's paid to get in front of a camera and talk about production agriculture. It's a farmer that's out there, and he has a vested interest in trying to convey his message in a way that the consumers will understand that it's through his long hours and dedication to food production that they're able to be the best fed, best clothed, best housed people on earth. And also they do it at the least possible cost.
But one of the most important undertakings during Mr. Wade's presidency was the effort to reform Mississippi's eminent domain law. After failing to get the reform measures through the legislature in four attempts, Farm Bureau launched an effort to get the Constitution changed through the initiative process. 9 months of signature gathering culminated in over 119,000 signatures being delivered to the Secretary of State's office in early October. The Secretary certified the signatures a few weeks later, and the initiative is now set to be on the ballot in November of 2011.
Well, I think it's a tremendous victory. It's a victory for every property owner in Mississippi.
A testament to someone's effectiveness can usually be best expressed by people who have worked with that individual.
David Wade has been a diligent and effective advocate for Mississippi farmers and livestock producers. I've had the pleasure of working with him on farm bills and many other legislative measures that affect agriculture since he took the reins of the Farm Bureau in 1996. David's ability to find solutions to problems affecting farmers, large and small, his business acumen, and his public service record have made him a very effective leader. He has certainly set a high standard for future Mississippi Farm Bureau presidents. We appreciate David and his wife, Sandra, for their years of service to the people of Mississippi.
David Wade is an example of a farmer who not only answered a call to serve, but also a call to lead. In fact, he is leaving a legacy of rock-solid leadership. David, I congratulate you on your retirement as president of the Mississippi Farm Bureau. I will miss your leadership and input as a member of the AFBF board. David, you will always be a part of the Farm Bureau family. We thank you for answering the call to serve and to lead.
I've had the pleasure of knowing David Wade for nearly two decades. In fact, I worked very closely with him while I was a member of Senator Thad Cochran's staff. I worked with him on farm bills and issues important to Mississippi agriculture and issues that are important to our nation's farmers and ranchers. David was always a straight shooter, someone who told you like it was, who stood up for Mississippi's farmers and ranchers, and was a big help to me and to Senator Thad Cochran. In my current position at Mississippi State University, I could not have a better partner than David Wade. He understands the importance of our mission at Mississippi State in research and extension, and I am so proud of the relationship and the partnership that Mississippi State University has with Mississippi Farm Bureau, in part because of his outstanding leadership. So David, on behalf of Mississippi State University and all your friends there, we want to wish you continued success with your future.
David, I want to take this opportunity to tell you what a joy it's been to work with you this past 14 years. You provided exceptional leadership, not only the Farm Bureau, but all of agriculture in Mississippi. And because of your efforts, Farm Bureau is stronger and agriculture in Mississippi is stronger. I couldn't have had a better friend or a better co-worker than David Wade through these years as we tried to make agriculture better and more prosperous for all of our people involved in agriculture. And my wish for you and your family as you enter these years of retirement is complete happiness and best wishes in the future.
I'm humbled by the vote. I greatly appreciate the effort everybody's made on my behalf.
Well, it's the greatest honor I've ever had, and I can assure you I'll ever have. You know, there's nothing better than just representing farmers. They are the salt of the earth. I have grown up and been a part of them, and they are the best stewards of the environmental resources we have. They are the best tenders of our animal. They provide care to the animals that they use in their production. They are out there when most people are in bed asleep, and it's calving or farrowing time, or maybe it's just a sub-freezing night in the poultry business, but they're out monitoring all of the things that have to be monitored on a livestock operation. And they know, while it's their livelihood, but they're out there because they care what happens to the animals. They know that they can't make a profit from an animal that is not well treated. And just to maintain the production practices that we've had on our farms can't be done if you don't have somebody that really believes in the cause. And farmers in general believe in the cause. They believe in working every day to continue that domestic supply of affordable food and fiber.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds when we're together?
Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather.
Happy trails to you till we meet again.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Distinguished Service Award for 2010 goes to the 8th President of the Mississippi Farm Bureau Federation, Mr. David Wade.
I just want to say, speaking for the Executive Committee of Mississippi Farm Bureau, the Mississippi Farm Bureau Board, and the entire organization of the Mississippi Farm Bureau Federation, we're honored to give you this.
Thank you. Thank you, Donald, and thank all of you. I can't tell you what this means to me, but I want you to all know that my efforts have always been a labor of love for agriculture. I know all of you know how I feel about the fact that if we ever lose our domestic food source, we'll be vulnerable to any country that supplies that. As Americans, we must never give up the ability to produce that which we consume. And I'm honored this afternoon to accept this on behalf of the farm community in Mississippi through the efforts that you all have helped me make at Farm Bureau. I believe that we have indeed fulfilled our mission statement for the 14 years that I've served, and that is to have a better life and make a better living for those that are members of the Mississippi Farm Bureau. But it's through your efforts that this has happened, not through mine. Thank y'all so very much.